RGB and ARGB on AM4 motherboards. First of all, thanks for subscribing and following us. This video is made with the purpose of supporting multi-language subtitling with artificial intelligence voice. But it will explain in detail to you how to choose a motherboard if you like RGB or ARGB. I prepared this video, since I have many questions from my subscribers, about the differences and how to configure these devices that give life and color to the PC, RGB and ARGB and their differences. Although there are many people who do not like them, PC gaming culture is based on constantly improving out of sheer enthusiasm. Gamer PCs bring more and more ARGB connectors, and although there are minimalist trends, and even terms like slipper PC, which on the outside looks like a normal PC and on the inside are a monster with RGB, or PC moding, in where ARGB or RGB always exists, these devices are enjoyed. As long as you have them well configured, and if you don't want them, they are simply turned off with software. They do not give you more FPS, nor more computational performance, just millions of colors and tones to your workspace and your PC. And it's a key difference from a gamer PC, to an office PC that doesn't have RGB or ARGB. So before buying a motherboard and if you want to take advantage of these connectors, there are tricks, but there is no definitive software that controls all devices. There is a lot of confusion, and we are going to get fully into this issue, which is not the fault of the users but of the owners of each technology, since they have not agreed to have a single standard connector for RGB and another for ARGB. Let's start from the base. The RGB is analog, has a standard connector of 4 pins and 12 volts, they use more power, while ARGB, or digital RGB, has a standard connector of 3 pins and 5 volts. Maintains the 4-pin thickness format. But it only brings 3. In addition to this, the vast majority of companies that manufacture RGB and ARGB products are very few that use the standard and manufacture, for example, fan kits with proprietary connectors that go directly to their hub or controller. Of course, for PC master race enthusiasts to buy everything from one brand. Obviously, this is its end. The good thing is that companies, knowing all the problems that exist in the RGB world, ensure that their product works independently of the connection to the motherboard, but we as buyers and PC enthusiasts do not buy all the components of the same brand when assembling our equipment, but the one that gives us the best quality and price to the components. Thus, we end up with Crosshair memories, Asus motherboards, Gigabyte graphics cards, AMD factory fans, but manufactured by Cooler Master, RGB LED strips, ASA ARGB fans and different brands, not to mention keyboards and mice, and other peripherals, that we can now synchronize from our PC. As buyers, when we go beyond the standard of the brands, when we want to synchronize all the RGB and ARGB from the software, we run into many problems. Especially because the software is also different for each brand and each product within it, something that also weighs heavily when using the devices. But first things first. Differences. RGB is the first generation that we saw a few years ago for gamer computers. Its main characteristic is that the connectors are 4-pin and 12-volt, and they give one color at a time. If you configure your PC with RGB devices, you can configure everything with a single color randomly, with different shades, but there is a big difference with ARGB or DRGB devices, which have 3 pins and are 5 volts and can be configured, and give effects customized to each LED, making the most of the brand's software. If we take Aura Sync, for example, the rainbow effect, with RGB or analog, on a LED strip it will look like this. All in one color. Same example, but with an ARGB strip it will look like this. Each LED will change accordingly with the colors of the rainbow. In the same way, if we take the effect of Aura Sync, color cycle, the entire PC, both RGB and ARGB devices, will look like RGB. All synchronized devices in a single color tone that you can change from the software. But, what if we take the Star Night effect? The RGB strips will look like little Christmas lights. While the ARGB there is a difference, each LED randomly changes the color. Like everything in technology, it is changing. Aura Sync now became Armory Create, and each brand is creating new software, being possible to create infinite effects, and they are evolving to digital DRGB or addressable RGB, since each LED can be given a different tone and color through the software. So, if you want a PC with ARGB or RGB, the first thing is to have a motherboard that supports and has these connectors. But RGB and ARGB are not available on all gamer motherboards. For this video we will focus on motherboards with a AM4 socket, for AMD Ryzen processors. From the first, to the last generation in motherboards, since I believe most of the gamer, we have AMD in mind, at least in 2020. Without going into fanaticism of brands. Likewise, these RGB or ARGB connectors are in the same categories for different Intel sockets. Also, if you buy a motherboard without these connectors, you should consider that the beautiful PC cases, which are being sold in the market, all have ARGB connectors. So if you buy a motherboard without these connectors, you can only take advantage of ARGB with a remote control, and you won't be able to sync from the software. Starting with the cheapest of all. The BioStar A320MH, the Gigabyte GA, A320M and the MSI, A520M. They support up to 3rd generation Ryzen processors, some with BIOS updates, and have been shown to hold up with the latest Ryzen 5000, with some BIOS beta, they cost between $55 to $65. But neither have RGB or RGB connectors. But this does not mean that you cannot connect memories, graphics cards connected to the board and that you can configure it with the brand software if it is compatible. But they have no connectors or pins, no RGB or ARGB. Starting with the B450 cards, like the Asus B450MA, we can already see an RGB connector on the top compatible with Aura Sync. But, how many meters of RGB can I put in a connector? Today there are many types of LED strips, but specifically LED strips for PC come with a standard of 1 meter, and some at a maximum of 13.8 inches or 2 meters, to ensure there are no voltage drops and the LED strip lights up equally, in all sections. But these, we can only connect them to a connector on the motherboard. If we want to connect two or more strips, we must connect a power supply or hub. The LED strip hubs are connected to a SATA port of your power source, and the maximum length of the LED cable that you can connect should not exceed 3 meters, to avoid voltage drops and prevent heating of the connectors of your motherboard. On B450 motherboards, M versions, both in brands such as ASRock, Asus or MSI, we find at least one analog RGB connector. Being in this category, the Gigabyte Aorus B450M, the only one I have found that has two ARGB connectors and two RGB connectors. If you know of other B450 serial motherboards that have more ARGB connectors, please post in the comments. And I appreciate your subscription, as this channel is not sponsored by any brand and our goal is to help. We also invite you to see our live video streaming section of video games, where you will find live-made videos of Dota 2, Call of Duty Warzone, Dying Light, and others that we are adding almost every day. Returning to the subject, in terms of ARGB and aesthetics, the Gigabyte Aorus B450M is better than the legendary Asus ROG Strix B450F, since it only has analog RGB connectors. We can get the B450 motherboards, between $60 and $125. Moving on to high mid-range motherboards, B550, the cheapest are the ASRock B550M motherboard. It has no RGB or ARGB connectors, but the Gigabyte Ultra Durable B550M Day has 3 ARGB and 2 RGB connectors, with a market value between $80 to $100. In addition, these motherboards have a PCI 4.0 connector, that is, they are prepared to get the best out of the new NVIDIA 3000 series and AMD 6000 series cards, and guarantee functionality with Ryzen 5000 processors. But in this category, almost all have ARGB and RGB. From the Asus Prime B550, for $100 we already find 3 and 4 pin connectors. In this category we find many options, but most have RGB and ARGB, some MSI do not have them, but in Gigabyte, MSI, Asus, ASRock brands, and depending on the M.2 connectors and build quality, we can find motherboards of this category costing more than $200. Right now, the high-end motherboards for Ryzen are from the X570 series. That in addition to having at least 2 M.2 storage expansion connectors and 128GB of RAM as standard, they have better dissipation, regardless of the brand, both for the chipset and for the processor, and all have RGB and ARGB. We can find X570 motherboards, in different brands from $180 to $450 up to 3 PCI 4.0 expansion slots. So, depending on your economic capacity, and to take advantage of the nice PC cases with ARGB they are selling in the market, most have ARGB connectors, and you should look for a motherboard that has these connectors if you like the ARGB. In addition, it is not necessary to marry a brand, that is, we users, we look for the best cost. My motherboard is Asus TUF X570 Plus, but the 128 of RAM is Crosshair, so to be able to configure the colors I must do it in the IQ software. Crosshair released a plugin for Asus, but it is not very good, so I have to configure the ARGB of the RAM in IQ, the fans, RGB and RGB strips, connected to the motherboard, I prefer to configure them in Armory Create by Asus. The factory Ryzen 3700X ARGB heatsink says, AMD, but it was made by Cooler Master, and to configure it, I must use the Wraith Prism software, which lets you configure the color of the AMD logo, the ARGB fan rings with various effects, and the ARGB of the processor fan, customizing colors to your liking. Important, you must connect only the USB connector to your motherboard, not the two cables. My graphic card is a Gigabyte 5700 XT of 8GB, OC, and the only LED that you can configure is the one for the logo. But the truth is I hope they improve the software, because the card is good, but the RGB software is not very good. The brands will surely be generating software to configure everything independently of the brand, at least that is what we PC enthusiasts dream of. If you know a software that controls everything, of all brands, put it in the comments so you will help the community. I hope I have helped you, and if you plan to update your motherboard, choose the one you like if you want to take advantage of the connectors. There is no point in buying a card with these connectors if you are not going to use them or you do not like RGB or ARGB. You can also turn them off from the software, or have a single color PC, or multicolor or whatever you want. Thank you, and if I forgot something or have any questions, please subscribe and leave your comments.